Highlights now, race number 18 of our championship. With drizzle falling at the very start of the race, and the pole sitter Cam Waters gets a ripping start off the line. In fact, his pace in the early phase was incredibly impressive. No gap down the inside for David Reynolds when he got down to turn two, and he interlocked wheels with Scott McLaughlin, broke the steering on car number nine, and it flattened the right rear tyre on McLaughlin's car. You can see the rim protruding there. Both of them had to come back into the pit lane. Meantime, the rain continued as this young man, Cam Waters, continued to extend his margin. A rare mistake for Jamie Whincup. Sits it up on the curb at turn six, fires it into the wall. It was wet and greasy out there, and we remarked on it earlier on. Punched the car into the fence. Damage on the front, damage on the rear. But they had to stop the car because it ran out of oil pressure. And that put paid to his afternoon. Because it was a safety car, it triggered a bunch of action. And all the questions arose. Do they go on to wets? Do they stay with slicks? And the pit lane gambled. But this young man in car number 99, Anton De Pasquale, got onto a wet tyre. And he made it work for him this afternoon. He was a bit shy on fuel at the back end of the race, which is ultimately what hurt. It got wetter. The visibility was shocking. There were some tremendous battles. Cam Waters went all the way down the escape road at turn two, managed to recover and got on the podium. But all afternoon, it was mistake-free for Shane van Gisbergen. He just continued to show that his prowess in the wet is extremely impressive. Now, the fuel cocked open on the Brad Jones Racing refuel rig. They had a big pool of racing fuel underneath the car, which ignited when Nick picked up the throttle. So Percat driving away from the pit lane ignites a massive amount of fuel, and then everybody had to jump on it and put it out. The car was then stranded at the end of the pit lane. The Red Bull Holden Racing Team and Shell V-Power Racing jumping into the action to help. Because of all those traumas around the racetrack, they had to finish this one under the Vodafone safety car, and it meant a victory for the Kiwi. The fast Kiwi is playing himself back into this championship. It's been a wild, slippery afternoon, but another memorable one. Our 11th visit in Townsville. We're looking forward to our next trip to Queensland Raceway in a couple of weeks.